We're going live right now. Three, two, one.
Take it away, Rose.
Are live again, hopefully with the video, since the visual arts kind of require that support. We are Palimpsest, the International Art Alliance Global International Collaborative Project, where we are sending paintings to one another to do a separate layer, each at a time, through snail mail across the world. We have Cheryl Wilcox down in Australia. Good morning. Thank you for joining us so early. We have Lara Spiteto in the UK. Hi, Lara.
Hi.
Stephanie McLean, Miss Jellybean Painter, Jellyfish Painter in the back there.
Well, they kind of like jelly beans. That's next.
Jellybean and Jellyfish all together, which I love. Stephanie is in Toronto, and Denise Friesman-Pilger is also in Toronto this week, although she's usually in Saint-Jérôme, Quebec, because Denise is doing the Artist Abroad at Nathan Phillips Square for the Toronto Outdoor Art Fair. And was that 3 days, Denise?
Yes. We're starting tomorrow, and it's running all the way to Sunday.
A marathon of art and talking. Good luck with that.
It's gonna be fun.
That's what they're all
about. I'm excited.
I am Rose L. Williams. I am also a visual artist. I would print with leaves and then paint into it. And I'm here in Vancouver. We are missing Ross C. Berman, who's in LA. And whenever he's not with us, there's a hole in our hearts because he's such a big part of our group. And I like to think of him as the heart and soul. But we are going to forge ahead without Ross this week, because I think we do have two of our test paintings to open. Okay, so this is how it works, people. We get to have the excitement of receiving something in the mail, something tangible that we can touch and smell and feel. And it has been sent by one of the six, or in this case, seven artists on, and this test paintings, our theme is transformation. So let's start with Cheryl down under, and we'll see how this transforms your face when you open it.
Oh my God, it's gotten so much more extra tape.
A few days ago. You can tell that multicolored pieces of tape would have to be an artist. And it's taped up really well.
We are recording this, right? Because this is cool.
Yes. We are recording this.
This is
we record everything, people.
Is it in the morning? Okay, so here it is. It's hidden in here, and I can see it appearing. There we go.
Wow.
She's so beautiful, Lara.
She is gorgeous.
She's really taking back a little bit for you, like that.
That's stunning.
Growing up.
So
he's growing up, is that what you said?
I said that I was thinking that my little girl is growing up.
Yeah.
She's beautiful.
So developing.
Yeah.
Okay, so Lara says this because this was the painting that Lara started in the UK. And it was originally a portrait of your daughter's, Hilaria's face, correct?
Yeah.
And it was then mailed to moi here in Vancouver. And then I did a layer. And then I mailed it to Ross. Ross did a layer. Ross mailed it to Stephanie.
Denise. Oh, me. Yeah.
Who worked
Denise,
on it?
Denise.
Yeah. I worked on it after Ross.
Okay, and now you sent it to, has it gone to Julie?
Not yet.
By the look of it.
Okay, so it has.
Julie,
so,
yeah.
No, I sent it to Stephanie, and then Stephanie sent it to Cheryl.
Yep. And I don't know that Julie is going to do anything on this one.
I'm not sure. I don't think so.
No, I don't think so. No.
Okay.
So you're the last one, Cheryl.
Yes.
I know. Okay.
No pressure.
So your layer will be the final touch.
The last one. Yeah. Okay.
Are you having any ideas?
I don't know. It's actually a lot more contrast so here. It's like here. It's probably my lighting sort of. The black is blacker rather than looking like a charcoal.
Same thing.
And it's all a little bit more colorful with this. I don't know. I think it's cerulean blue here. And it has some, what do you call them? Fluoro colors just here. There's a few spots of fluoros, here.
Fluorescence, yeah.
Yep. Okay. And it has some collage and these flower pieces here, these leaves which are over here, that's actually collage just there. We've got some really nice golden highlights in the hair. There you go.
She really is maturing.
Yeah.
I would love to know, actually, Stephanie, you were the last one to work on this before Cheryl, right? What did you do with her?
Mm-hmm. So I read and you know what, this is gonna sound crazy because I did so little, but I put so much thought into it, I really did. I read the document. So we have what we're gonna call a passport for all intents and purposes, that just basically a document that goes around with every painting. And so I read, you know, all of the previous entries. And Lara's initial entry was a lot about balance, basically. If you have dark, you have to, like, you can only have light if you have dark, right? Something to contrast it against. So because there was, you know, the dark side of Valeria's face and the light side, and then there's the fire, I thought, well, to balance the fire, I'll add some water. So those two little drips in the bottom, in the bottom there, that was me. Two blue
drips. That's awesome.
I like them because they mirror the wings or the fire in shape and value. I like that. It's working for me.
Yeah.
Good.
And I also really like that you went through this whole thought process and ended up with just these little I just wanted to express how that is totally awesome and totally okay, because I know we all feel like it should not be okay because it's such a little thing that you add, but it's fine.
Yeah,
it's perfect.
I tried to match as closely as possible the blue that was already there. I see from here it looks like it's not exactly right, but I was using acrylic inks, so I was mixing two different blues and white and trying to arrive at that exact color.
What were you mixing? What two blues were you using?
I think there was maybe a thallo blue and a Prussian blue with some white. Does that make sense?
Yeah,
it's got thallo in it. I thought it was sort of a lot like a cerulean, like
It looks more cerulean there. Yeah, mm-hmm. It does. I don't have cerulean acrylic inks, so it wasn't cerulean. Cerulean, however we say that. Yeah.
Whatever. Yeah. It's a great name, isn't it?
So's phthalo. Phthalo.
Phthalo.
Phthalo. Phthalo blue. Phthalo green.
I always thought it would be really nice to call your family, you know, members azure and. You know, cerulean and magenta, I suppose.
Ultramarine.
Yeah. That's why my dog is cobalt. He's cobalt.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's perfect.
Yeah. So do you have any
ideas? Do we have another painting?
Oh, all the way in Toronto. Yeah. I brought it with me.
I can't wait to see what this painting turns into with Cheryl's touch.
Yes.
I bet Lara is going to be like, this painting is all here.
Sorry.
I would love to know, Lara, how does it feel to see it evolve like this for you?
It's amazing. It's amazing because at the beginning, every time I can see it seems like complete, but every time that you add something, it's more complete. So I want to see what Cheryl will add to it.
Yeah, me too.
I love that everybody's so excited for some another artist to touch their paintings.
Yeah, it's pretty much working now.
Yeah.
I mean, you're attracted to the eye, so there's a really nice focal point.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it's pretty much, which is nice that we're looking at the eye. Yeah.
Sorry.
That's your challenge, Cheryl. All right, let's open Denise's package.
Yes, this came all the way from Australia. It came all the way from Australia. Yeah, it took the long way around. And now I brought it from Montreal with me to Toronto because I wanted to open it here. I don't have any tools. Yeah, it is.
Can we say where Denise is sitting, Rose?
I don't know. Do you want to reveal where you are?
I'm literally
not exact.
Like in the hallway. Across from the elevator. And people keep walking by and looking at me like really weirdly. Like, what is this lady doing here in the hallway?
I appreciate your sacrifice.
Okay, I'm so excited about this. This is painting B.
She's sitting
and
on the floor in the hallway.
I know. Ooh.
Drum roll, please.
It has so many I just love this.
Nice.
I don't know who does this, because I didn't do it on mine, but I love it so much. Just the experience of opening this, and there's doodles here. Like, I think it's just paints and stuff.
Yes, be Stephanie.
And then here too, on the inside, there's like paints. Flex, and I just love that experience. And then there's another piece. Oh, it's sticking actually a little bit.
So has it been on? How long has it been on Ross's desk for?
Oh, it's good. It's okay. It's okay.
Coffee.
Oh wow. Oh, this is. I thought it was another one. This is the one where that doesn't have a direction anymore.
Okay.
Julie's, this is the one. Julie's painting. Yeah.
Julie started.
This is awesome. Oh my god. You did so much to it, Cheryl. Wow.
We want to see.
I know. I'll show you. Wait, I'm going to pin myself so it's larger. There we go.
Look yourself. Okay.
So I don't know.
Wow. A dragonfly.
It works all the ways.
Oh my gosh.
Rose, you painted the dragonfly, right?
Yeah,
Rose
did
the dragonfly.
Yes.
It kind of works like this too.
Hi. Can you see the high in the sky?
Yes. Here.
Oh, cool.
Wow.
That's great.
But it works in all the ways.
Or the sunrise. Yeah. Oh, that's so cool.
I kind of like that it also works like this, where this is the dark sky, and then this could be water.
On a rotating frame for people to be able to do that too.
Yeah. I know.
Well, affix a lazy Susan to the wall and just glue that to it.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Oh, it's.
Am I the last one on this one?
It is.
No.
I am.
You are.
Great.
Ha ha.
What the hell am I gonna do?
That is awesome.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
What a tornado.
But look, guys, there is so much.
Be, right?
Wait, I want to show you because there's this texture.
Can you see that? The texture of the...
The
blue?
It's sort of pastels or something, or it's so cool.
It's hard to see.
It's beautiful. Cheryl, yeah. I love what you did.
So I think that was the ink. And so somebody had put, previous artist had, that was like a fellow ink that was there.
Yeah. So I'd love to know, Cheryl, what you did to it and why.
Sorry, what?
Yes. What did you
add? So it had a lot of white in it. So I just started to paint it, and I was just trying to, I was trying to get rid of the white.
Well, then you succeeded. Because it pulled it all together. What you did.
Well, I was trying to actually, and then I read through it, and it was the yin and the yang. And so I was working with, because the fellow is like a cool blue, and so I put the warm ultramarine on the other side. So I was just working with that concept of the opposites, or the, and I was just trying to just almost like get rid of the white. I was just trying to pull it down. I don't know. Is that art?
No, it's great. It's so cool. It is working. So
I was trying to nail it down a little bit. I was trying to bring the elements together.
Cool. Wow.
Well, on the basis of these two paintings, which aren't quite finished yet, this test run is going to be 7 really amazing little paintings. Like, I think we'll be ready to do our submissions pretty soon.
I think so too.
Amazing.
So,
but with our 7 little pieces, like, don't we have to?
Well, we have to submit.
Yeah.
They need to have an idea of what we're creating.
Yeah, I think.
And I think this is very solid. Yeah, I agree with Rose. I wanted to suggest.
They will be ready once these are done. We have to let each other know, take good photos, load them up so that I can start submitting.
Yes.
Because now the curators will have something to base their decision on.
Yep, right. I agree.
Okay.
So I wanted to interject real quick. It's 3:57, but since we started about 10 minutes late, is everybody okay running 10 minutes longer? Because...
Yep.
We actually have a question from one of our viewers that I wanted to ask each and every one of you before we end.
Great.
Okay.
Yeah? Is everybody down with that? Awesome.
Okay, I'm down with it, man.
We have Nakamura Ikumi-san from Japan, and she is asking each and every one of us, when we decided we wanted to become artists. So, Lara, would you like to answer that first?
Yeah. I don't know when I decided. I can answer in 2 ways. The first one is that I always, from all my life, I wanted to be an artist as I was a child. But it was like too much, because to be an artist is something so big. That it's not a simple word, it's not a job, it's not something that you feel inside. And sometimes it's a word too important to say I'm an artist. And when I decide to describe, to tell that I'm an artist, it was when I made my first exhibition in Barcelona, and I remember that also when I went to renew my documents, and they asked me what job I was doing, and I said I'm an artist, and I felt so full inside. So, but sometimes I'm asking myself, what does it mean to be an artist? Because it's not something, it's something that you learn every day, you improve, you are a whole. So old. So maybe, yeah, from when I was born and at the same time, I'm still balancing to learn and to believe that I might have.
That's awesome. Thank you, Lara. Rose, would you like to share your answer with us?
What was the question?
The question was when you decided you wanted to become an artist.
When did I decide I wanted to be an artist? For me, actually, at a certain point, I tried to decide not to be, but I was unable to follow through with that. So I think that I was probably born an artist, and because of the time and place I was born in, it wasn't such a cool thing to be or to say that you were. But I was waking up when I was 6 years old, waking up from dreams with the deep need to paint or draw the dream that I just had. I'm not sure why. Maybe I wanted to share with other people. Maybe I just wanted to remember it. But I started doing that really young. And then I used to dance and sing and play instruments and just be the crazy creative kid, talk to fairies down the street and stuff. And to this day, I still think that I'm, you know, there's other beings in the forest. It's and not everybody else sees them.
You do.
Yes, I know.
I agree.
Right there.
Yes.
They're there. I have a photo that I took recently of all the vapor coming off of a tree, and it had like a hazy glow around the tree, and I actually got a photo of it. So they're there.
That's cool. I just got chills. So, that's
and then cool. To be perfectly honest with you guys, I had a psychedelic experience when I was probably about 15 years old, and I knew that there was nothing else that I was going to be able to do in my life because that's what I was supposed to do. So
wow.
I don't know what the measure of success as an artist is because I don't make a lot of money doing it, but I know that I've never stopped doing it and I have touched people's lives with my art. So to me, that's successful, honestly.
Yeah, I know.
Awesome.
Cool.
Thank you, Rose.
I want to hear more about the psychedelic experience at some point.
Cheryl, tell us about your story. When did you decide when you wanted to become an artist?
It's always been with me also. And I've always sort of known that I was going to tread the world as an artist. And I suppose art was always my favorite subject. It was natural for me. I always came first in art, all that sort of stuff. It was natural for me to go to art school, but the same insecurities of not being good enough or not being able to after myself. So I had a career as an art teacher, and it's really only been about the last five, maybe the last few years that I have really been practicing my own art, and I have been really honing my own skills. And I have students now, and I have an exhibition arranged for them. So I've always got to be really careful of how much energy I put into everybody else. And I know that I find it really easy to slip into this helping everybody else. Whereas I think sometimes to be an artist, I think you really have to be you have to really work on yourself and on your own skills. You really have to be sort of selfish with your time, to your Greek guys.
Right.
And
right.
So I often think that it's, I don't know, the way that I was brought up anyway, it was this idea that it was, well, yeah, and anyway, so at least now I'm exploring it a little bit more.
Thank
but I'm
goodness.
Mindful. Yes, but yeah. I'm mindful that I'm just sort of mindful of how much energy and how much work I put into classes and other people. And I think, no, come on. You've just got to, anyway.
Save some for yourself. Yeah.
Yeah. Stephanie, how would you answer this question?
So I also have always been an artist, but not always a visual artist. I was always creative as a kid, putting on shows for the neighbors, like just, you know, You do, yeah. Playing instruments, playing piano, singing. Like, I had to be, and for me, it was creative, and it was really, like, I had to express myself, and everybody had to watch and hear me express myself. So I was in theater and singing and all of that stuff. And then after university, and I graduated with a Bachelor of Fine Arts in music in university, although I was painting in university, but that wasn't my focus. After university, you know, and being with my band for, I don't know, about 5 years post-university, I moved to Toronto, met my husband, had to get a full-time job. So then I went into the corporate world for, I don't know, 25 years, or a long time. And that's when I was still creating, still, you know, doing graphic design and stuff. Never felt fully fulfilled until I was let go and decided to pursue visual arts full time. I was already painting, you know, from about, I guess, 2018, 2019. And then during the pandemic, I got much more into it. And yeah, that's my story.
Awesome. Well, then I will. I guess I'll go last. Yes. I, like you, I've also always, like each and every one of you, I've always been drawing and painting. And ever since I was really, really little, like drawing and painting has always been my favorite subject in school. But I also played the violin. I did theater, and I really knew that I wanted to do something creative. Ideally, I wanted to be an actress, but I kind of, when I was in high school, I think, I sort of like, well, I think I'm a little bit stronger of an artist than I'm an actress, because I could never ever hold my laughter. Whenever I was on stage, I always had to laugh. So that's not very helpful. So I was like, maybe I should just do this painting thing instead. And I still feel really blessed that my parents allowed me to go to art school, because they were adamant though that I was allowed to go to art school, but I had to learn a trade. So I was not allowed to do fine arts. I had to learn something that was actually sort of useful. So I studied illustration instead, which is actually, in hindsight, probably a better choice, because at that time in Holland, in art school, it was all very focused on idea development. While illustration, on the other hand, you learned all of the techniques. So I got to do photography, I got to do printing, I got to do oil paints, acrylics, watercolors, like all of the things, which for me, especially as a mixed media artist, of course, I got to touch everything. So that's actually a much better education, I think, for a fine artist as well. So I think, yeah, that's sort of my story. It's a little here and there, but.
That's pretty cool that you had that fork in the road that just turned out to, you know, be for the best in the long run for you.
Yeah.
As your development as an artist.
Well, and then
of those two.
Yeah, there was actually a stronger fork, because when I left art school, that was right about the time 9/11 happened. So that was when the economy crashed, and I left art school, and there was no work. There wasn't anything as an illustrator. As an illustrator in general in Holland, the market is really, really small. So I rolled into graphic design, and I became a graphic designer. I taught myself in design and became a graphic designer until the moment I moved to America. I followed my husband to America, and I for about a year I worked as a freelancer, but then the company that I worked for went bankrupt. And I got to sort of, I tried to figure it out as a freelancer for a while there, but then eventually I was like, you know what? I'd just much rather paint. So instead of, and then I moved to Montreal at that time, and I had a very hard time getting into the graphic design scene, not speaking French. So I kind of had to make the choice. Am I going to look for work outside of Canada, or am I just going to switch gears all together and just start doing this fine art thing? So I think it was 2010 that I officially became a full-time visual artist.
Good for you, because now everybody in Nathan Phillips Square can enjoy your paintings.
Yes.
That's right.
So I think we're about at our time. So Rose, I think you may, I think we can end it right here. We have about five minutes left on the clock.
Yeah, no, thanks for joining us, everybody. And it's too bad Ross couldn't be here. We missed him. But hopefully next week we will see you guys back here at the same time, same place, with no glitches at all. And we'll start on time, 3:30 Eastern Standard Time, 12:30 Pacific. And look forward to seeing you all.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Okay, I ended the...